Welcome to this session. This session will discuss about the classification of definiteness of a quadratic form. So we start by giving a few definitions before we go into the real classification. So canonical form. So B is a diagonal matrix then the transformed quadratic is a sum of square terms known as canonical form. So the first term. Next term is what we call index. So the number of positive terms in a canonical form of a quadratic form is known as index denoted by small s of the form or of the quadratic form. Now, there's also another term we call the rank of a quadratic form. The rank of a quadratic form denoted by small r of matrix B or A, as I've seen in the discussion earlier, is called the rank of the form. That's what you have. And then another term before we go into specific classification is what we call signature of the quadratic form. Signature. So the difference The difference of positive terms S and negative terms given by R minus S is known as the signature of the quadratic form. So signature is given by S minus R minus S, and this will be S minus R plus S, which will be 2S minus R. So that is the formula that specifies the signature of a quadratic form. So let's now go into the classification now. That was the main thing, classification. So let Q be the quadratic form. And variables x1, x2, x3, up to xn. Let the rank of this matrix A be small r, and let the index be small s. Then these are the special names for the quadratic forms. It's what we call positive, definite, and to describe a quadratic form as positive definite is when rank and index are equal. That is, R equals to N, S equals to N, or you can describe the quadratic form as positive definite if all the eigenvalues of A are positive if the eigenvalues of the matrix A are positive. So the key term here is all, and then positive. Next type of quadratic form or classification is what we call negative definite. This is when index 0, i.e. R equals to N and S equals to 0, or when all the eigenvalues of A are negative. So the key thing in this definition for negative definite is all eigenvalues should be negative or index is zero. Number three is what we call positive semi-definite. This is when the rank and the index are equal but less than n, i.e. S equals to R, but all of them are less than n. So this determinant of A is zero. Or you can say when all eigen values of A are negative, are positive, not negative, are positive, but and at least one eigen value is zero. So that's how we define positive semi-definite. And similarly, we have negative semi-definite. Negative number four semi-definite. This is when index is zero, i.e., s equals to zero, r is less than n, or all eigen values of A are negative, and at least one eigenvalue is zero. And then lastly, number five is what we call indefinite. This occurs if some eigenvalues are positive and some eigenvalues are negative. When some eigenvalues are negative and some are positive. So NB one if Q is negative definite or semi-definite, then negative Q is positive definite or semi definite. Number two, the classification of the definiteness of a quadratic form depends upon the location of the eigenvalues of A, the location of the eigenvalues of A. So in the next session, we'll see examples on how to do those classifications and how to transform a given quadratic form into canonical form. Thank you.